गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ आवर आई गेस सेवेंथ लेक्चर एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हैबिटेट। नाउ इन एन वाइल स्टडिंग इकोसिस्टम वी हैव स्टडीड हाउ हैबिटेट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट। हैबिटेट मीन्स द फिजिकल एनवायरनमेंट वेयर लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स लिव। हाउ दिस हैबिटेट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर एन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म बिकॉज ऑल इट्स नीड्स आर गेट फुलफिल्ड इन दैट स्पेस ओनली। इन दैट स्पेस फिजिकल एंड बायोलॉजिकल, बायोटिक एंड अबायोटिक फैक्टर्स इंटरैक्ट इन एन ऑर्गेनिक फैशन टू प्रोवाइड अ वेरी गुड शेल्टर फॉर एन ऑर्गेनिज्म, इजंट इट? इफ एन ऑर्गेनिज्म हैज़ अ फ्लरिशिंग हैबिटेट देन इट विल डायरेक्टली positively, it will directly impact positively to the ecosystem। अगर habitat अच्छा है किसी भी ecosystem में तो वो ecosystem है काफ़ी flourishing रहेगी, काफ़ी dynamic रहेगी। इससे क्या होगा, जो पूरा जो वहाँ का suppose for example forest है तो वहाँ का जो forest है उसकी अच्छी growth होगी, उसकी ecosystem अच्छी होगी, उसकी prey predator relationship अच्छी होगी, वहाँ के सारे फैक्टर्स जो फॉरेस्ट के लिए चाहिए वो अच्छे होंगे। अब किसी भी ऑर्गेनिज्म के लिए इम्पोर्टेंट क्या है, दे नीड स्पेस। स्पेस होना बहुत ज़रूरी है। दे नीड फूड, फूड इज़ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट। विदाउट फूड ऑल ऑर्गेनिजम्स विल डाई। सो इफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स स्टार्ट कंपीटिंग फॉर द फूड दे विल स्टार्ट डिस्प्लेसिंग वन अनादर, isn't it? So there must be abundant food available for organisms. Water, water is life. Without water nothing is possible. So water is very important factor for an habitat. Air is very essential. See, space, food, water and air, these are important factors for an good habitat. Okay? See, there are different kinds of habitat in biosphere. There are forest habitat. Now, we have seen while discussing biome, we have seen one example of equatorial forest. We can call it as an rainforest. उसे हम rainforest भी कह सकते हैं। दुनिया के 50% species इस rainforest में रहते हैं। About 50% of the world species live in rainforest or equatorial forests. See, then next thing is oceanic habitat. हमने marine biotic factors में देखा था कि marine life में कितनी biodiversity होती है। For example, in oceanic habitat we see coral reefs. Coral reefs are also called as rainforest of the marine ecosystem because coral reefs support a lot of organisms, a great kind of biodiversity you will find here. Okay, this is also a great habitat. Then fresh waters. See, you can see fresh water in rivers, lakes, ponds, even in polar regions you can get fresh water after melting of ice. Many organisms thrive in fresh waters, lot of birds, lot of fishes are supported by these fresh waters. You see concept of wetland, a tremendous amount of biodiversity is available in wetlands, isn't it? Then you see polar regions, there are harsh climatic conditions, even temperature go up to minus 60 to 90 degree, but there are also animals, microorganisms, plants thrivingly adapted. They are adapted to these harsh climatic conditions also. Now you see deserts, deserts are also a kind of habitat. There are also a lot of organisms develop certain kind of adaptations, certain kind of behaviors to interact with that component of ecosystem. Even there is a less moisture content, less water available in the habitat, but they have developed certain adaptations to live in a less amount of water and moisture. Now mountains are also a great kind of habitat. They support a lot of biodiversity. There are different projects are going on to protect and support the mountainous biodiversity. Okay. Now we have seen what is habitat. We have seen how different types of habitats are there. Now the question is how these organisms created certain behaviors to interact with that habitat so that they can live there happily. They can live in a particular fashion so that their survival is supported. See, there is a concept of evolution. There is a concept of evolution. It is called as New Darwinism. Evolution is a long, prolonged process. जब से अर्थ का निर्माण हुआ है तब से इवोल्यूशन की धीरे धीरे शुरुआत हुई. लाइफ ओरिजिनेटेड इन वाटर एंड देन केम ऑन टू द लैंड, इजंट इट? एंड इट अडाप्टेड इन वाटर एज वेल एज ऑन लैंड. तो इवोल्यूशन होता क्या है? ओके, अब हम इसे एक पर्टिकुलर फैशन में समझते हैं. देखिए, देर आर टू ऑर्गेनिजम्स. सपोज देर इज एन इकोसिस्टम, देर आर टू ऑर्गेनिजम्स. लेट्स सी, देर आर टू टाइगर्स, अ मेल एंड फीमेल, टाइगर एंड टाइग्रेस. ओके, दे प्रोड्यूस सर्टन ऑफ स्प्रिंग्स. लेट्स सी, 2, 3, 4, दे प्रोड्यूस 4 ऑफ स्प्रिंग्स. ऑफ स्प्रिंग्स आर वॉट? They get genetic material from father and mother. Now here they will get genetic material from tiger and tigress. The genetic material in the offspring is recombined. There is a genetic recombination in the offspring of that child. There is a recombination of genetic material in that offspring from the father and mother. So it shows characteristics, features of both father and mother, isn't it? Now some offsprings are robust, some are very dynamic, but some are weak, isn't it? So there are variations produced in an offspring. Kuch tarah ke variations develop hote hain, morphological, physiological, because of genetic recombination. Variations are expressed in an offspring. Now each offspring will have a particular kind of genetic makeup. Unme aisa genetic makeup hoga, they will use that genes for the adoption in particular environment. Isn't it? Now they will interact with the environment. They will interact with the immediate environment. And what will happen? Nature will select certain organisms who are robust, who are healthy, who are more immune to particular kind of disasters or epidemics. So such naturally selected organisms reproduce more because they are living, others will die, and these will reproduce more And so, in such a way, now the organisms having unique genes will survive and adapt into the environment, isn't it? तो स्टोरी ये है कि फादर मदर से ऑफ स्प्रिंग्स में जीन्स आएंगे, अलग अलग जीन्स की वजह से वेरिएशंस दिखाई देंगे, वेरिएशंस होंगे तो जो एक सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट कंसेप्ट है उस हिसाब से सबसे फिट ऑर्गेनिज्म विल लिव एडॉप्ट विद द एनवायरनमेंट. एज देयर आर लॉट ऑफ वेरिएशंस देयर इज बायोडाइवर्सिटी. Okay, so that ecosystem or that biome will have a great kind of a vast amount of diversity. Okay, chalo hum we'll see next. Now see, there are three kinds of crocodiles in India: freshwater, saltwater. Okay, but once in their life period, suppose 50 to 1 lakh years before, they were having common ancestor. Okay, but when they transferred to different habitat, let's consider salt water, let's consider fresh water, they evolved in a certain way and they developed in a certain way. They have some unique morphological characters, physiological characters, so they can live in that particular habitat. Let's see one by one. This is saltwater crocodile. In India we see saltwater crocodiles. They are found in Odisha, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal. In coastal areas we will find these crocodiles. There is an institution called IUCN, और IUCN ने उसको कहा है कि this is the least concerned animal because they are in abundant number. What is IUCN, what it does, etc. we'll see in some incoming lectures. The concept here is we have a sort of saltwater crocodile in India which lives in Odisha, West Bengal and Tamil Nadu. It has some unique features. Okay. Now see gharial. Gharial is an freshwater crocodile. It lives in rivers, flowing rivers. Okay. The major population of gharial is found in tributaries of Ganges, Chambal and Girwa. In India we find these crocodiles in tributaries of Ganga, Chambal and Girwa. Even Mahanadi also. Okay. There is a National Gharial Wildlife Sanctuary in Chambal. And now we see this freshwater gharial is a critically endangered animal. Okay. This is critically endangered. मैं आपको यहाँ पे इसलिए ये बता रहा हूँ कि हैबिटेट के हिसाब से इन क्रोकोडाइल्स ने अपने आप को अडाप्ट किया है एक पर्टिकुलर एनवायरनमेंट में रहने के लिए. ठीक है. सी देर इज अनदर क्रोकोडाइल इज कॉल्ड मगर. इट इज मीडियम साइज्ड क्रोकोडाइल. फ्रेश वाटर लेक्स, पॉन्ड्स, स्लगिश रिवर्स, स्वैम्प्स, marshes, these are the habitats of this mugger. This mugger is found throughout the Indian continent, subcontinent, and in IUCN category it is vulnerable. Okay, so see, these are three different habitats and three different adaptations to live in. Okay. See another example. See polar bear, red panda, they have common ancestor bear, but now they are developed in such a way and adapted to their local environment. See, polar bear adapted to icy environment. Okay. And red panda, it is adapted to its forest environment. Both animals shared a common ancestor once. See, there is also brown bear, black bear. They also develop certain adaptations. See, polar bear can live in minus 40 to 60 degrees centigrade. His body is adapted to harsh and cold climatic conditions. Isn't it? The ice is very important factor for polar bear. Sea ice is very important factor because it feeds on seals. Seals are animals. But nowadays, see, sea ice is decreasing, isn't it? Because of climate change, global warming, sea ice is decreasing at 5% per decade. Okay. And so, seals will lose their habit. Seals ke liye sea ice nahi rahega. Polar bears will suffer. In due course of time, they may get extinct. Khatam ho ja sakte. See, the sea ice is very important habitat for polar bear, isn't it? Now see another example. Red panda. Red panda is in Sikkim. It is found in Arunachal Pradesh, Darjeeling district of West Bengal, okay, Western Arunachal, in mountainous regions. In bamboo forest, you find red panda. It lives on tree. See, this is sleepy animal, lives on tree. Okay. It goes on eating. Grass leaf, forest mein bamboo leaves, bamboo sticks khate rehte hain. It is also a state animal of Sikkim. Sikkim ka state animal hai. But see, issue here is habitat. Its habitat is under destruction. This forest ecosystem is under destruction. So, state government, central governments are trying to restore its ecosystem. The bamboo forest, so that red panda can live there. Okay, red pandas are endangered animals. Okay, these are endangered animals. The issue here is that I want to show you that, see, habitat, how habitat is important. Okay, now see, Asiatic cheetah, a glamorous example. See, Asiatic cheetah is extinct in India. In 1952, it was declared as an extinct animal. In food chain or in food web, we lost this animal. Isn't it? Ecosystem mein agar koi animal extinct ho jata hai, uska bahut hi bura prabhav, बुरा असर पड़ता है पूरे इकोसिस्टम पे. ओके, नाउ व्हाट वी आर डूइंग टू रीइंट्रोड्यूस्ड चीता इनटू इंडियन स्टेट, इनटू इंडिया. वी आर ट्राइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस अफ्रीकन चीता. देर आर एशियाटिक चीताज स्टिल अवेलेबल. Still are there in critically endangered list. They are in Iran, but Iran denied कि हम आपको हमारे चीता नहीं देंगे. So what we have to do? We have to search another option, and another option is African cheetah. But see, morphologically it is different from Indian cheetah. That is the issue. Okay. Indian cheetah was smaller. This is bigger one, Africa. We are introducing it from Namibia. ओके वी आर गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस इट इन एमपी नौरादेही सेंचुरी. व्हाट? नौरादेही सेंचुरी. ओके द इशू हेयर इज दैट African cheetah is an alien species for Indian environment. It can displace some other species because it can compete for food for with other species, and it can displace in competition. It can displace other species in competition for food. That is the issue. See habitat. How habitat is important. Isn't it? अगर हमें अपना नेचुरल स्पेसिस नहीं मिलेगा दैट वी हैव लॉस्ट एशियन चीता तो हैबिटेट पे इकोसिस्टम पे इसका बहुत बुरा असर पड़ सकता है. दैट इज़ द इशू. ओके हम ये सब चीज़ें आगे आने वाले चैप्टर्स में पढ़ेंगे डिटेल में. आई एम जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूसिंग यू टू दिस कंसेप्ट ऑफ हैबिटेट. ओके Now another example. See Asiatic lion. एक ज़माना था जो Asiatic lion जो है वो वेस्ट बंगाल तक इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट में हमें दिखता था, इंडिया में दिखता था, अप टू स्टेट ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल, एमपी में था. ठीक है But now it is restricted to only Gir forest area. No other place have Asiatic lions in India other than Gir forest. It is an endemic species, the new concept. Endemic species. Because it is available only in the Gir forest. एक particular local area में ही है इसलिए इसे हमें endemic species कहते हैं. ठीक है जैसे एक लायन टेल मकाकू एक स्पेसीज है जो सदर्न इंडिया में फॉरेस्ट एरिया में पाया जाता है. दैट इज़ एन एंडेमिक स्पेसीज. द इशू हेयर इज हैबिटेट. हैबिटेट डिस्ट्रक्शन हुआ है यहाँ पे इसलिए ये जो लायन है दिस इज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू ओनली गिर फॉरेस्ट एरिया. यू सी एशियाटिक लायंस आर नाउ available we can see them in Saurashtra region of Gujarat. Now I want to introduce you to the new concept monotypic habitat. क्योंकि Asiatic lion एक ही जगह पर available है. It is a monotypic habitat. We see in agriculture monoculture. मोनोकल्चर में इन्फेक्शन या पेस्ट डिस्ट्रक्शन पेस्ट की वजह से डिस्ट्रक्शन होने के चांसेस काफ़ी ज़्यादा होते हैं. अगर किसी भी एरिया में डाइवर्सिटी बहुत ज़्यादा होती है तो दे आर वेरी इम्यून टू पेस्ट अटैक. ओके बट हेयर वी सी इट इज़ अ मोनोटाइपिक हैबिटेट सो वी वांट टू रीलोकेट दिस एनिमल्स एशियाटिक लायंस somewhere in India. We have selected a Palpur Kuno sanctuary in MP to relocate this Asiatic lion in MP. Why? Because of monotypic habitat. Isn't it? See how important the concept of habitat. Okay? Habitat destruction is the major topic today. In the world, in India, in everywhere, habitat destruction. See, we are losing species, different organisms. We are losing different organisms day by day. Why? Because of their habitat destruction. Say, there is a concept, sixth mass extinction. Okay. What is it? कि पहले 5 एक्सटिंक्शन के एपिसोड्स हो चुके हैं, स्पेसीज लॉस हो चुका है. दिस इज द 6th वन. and the primary cause is habitat destruction. We are losing species day by day. Okay. Now there are some points why habitat destruction is going on. We are harvesting natural resources. We are digging the earth. We are cutting forests. So what we are doing? We are fragmenting their habitat, the natural habitat. We are industrializing. For the development purpose, we have started big industries, and we are still in competition with the world to start bigger and bigger industries, isn't it? But what is happening? Habitat destruction. We are releasing chemicals on land, water, sea, everywhere, isn't it? It is infecting. It is infecting animals. It is creating genetic mutations in animals. Urbanization. The cities are sprawling. We are entering into the forest domain, isn't it? And so what? Man-animal conflict? A new episode starts. We daily read newspapers, we see man-animal conflicts. Isn't it? Climate change. Another bigger and dangerous concept, climate change. The climate is changing. The climatic conditions of the habitats are changing. So what? These organisms have to adapt the new emerging climatic conditions, isn't it? Now this example of polar bear, the sea ice is melting. Sea ice is melting. Now what? They have to adapt themselves in such a disastrous sequence of events. These animals may lose their habitat. They may die. They may even get extinct. Climate change. Mining, digging, we are digging the earth, we are destructing habitat. Another method, trawling, it is a fishing technique. We will see this trawling process in next chapters. But right now, see this, because of this trawling, habitat is getting destructed. Okay, now invasion of species. I told you African cheetah, it is alien species for our environment. There are a lot of alien species. If they enter into the particular habitat, they may displace the local species, isn't it? What is happening is species loss because of habitat destruction. Species loss. So what central government, state governments are doing? They are legally protecting legal habitats. They are legally protecting habitats. They are protecting animals by constitutional and by enacting laws. Okay, there are constitutional clauses. There are laws enacted. See, habitat, how important is the concept? Have you understood how habitat is very important concept? If you have any doubts, please, in a comment section, you can write doubts and we will answer it. Okay? If you like this lecture, please like, subscribe and forward it to others. Okay? This is a free endeavor for you only. Okay? Thank you.